love kick starts again. Starts again. It's the same old you, the same old me. You get bored and I get cold feet. Get high, get wandering eyes. Forget I've never ever had it so sweet. I realize what I've got when I'm out of town. Cause deep down you're my girl in the golden crown. My princess and I don't wanna let you down. No, I don't wanna let you down. Down, 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 down.
So Chris, can you tell me a little bit more about the Sky Sports and your association with it?
Yeah, well, basically it's set up so that Olympic athletes or world-class athletes can go around schools and obviously express how they've gotten to their top, how they've done it, all the success tools, and just engaging with youngsters who maybe might not be involved in sport, maybe involved in, maybe gifted and talented, but really getting out there and speaking to the wider audience and try to re-engage them that anything's possible. You know, a couple of the success tools that I talk about when I come in today, really simple things that maybe some of the pupils are already doing, just need a little bit refining on their skills and help them to understand that actually normal people doing extraordinary things is happening on their doorstep. Why can't it be them? Can they? And the love kick starts again.
So how did you actually get involved?
I saw the Sky Sports Olympic for Sport advertised and I thought, you know what, I really want to get out there and inspire someone, the next generation. And that's part of my dream now. And my, you know, I want to go out and inspire the next generation to do something. And I think the time's right to do that. You know, I've got a short window of opportunity to do that. I love coming around the schools and meeting new staff, pupils, being shown around the schools and just doing something different. You know, it's not a normal 9-to-5, it's getting out there and being active.
What sort of reaction do you feel that you've got from them today?
Obviously mixed when you first come in. People think, who's this punk? What's he going to say? What's he going to do? But, you know, by the end of the day, hopefully they know me a little bit better. They know where I've come from, what I do. But they also go away with that sense of, well, he can do it, I can do it. There's nothing extraordinary about me. The only thing that was extraordinary was I broke away from the pack and I was able to follow my dream. My dream was to be an Olympic champion in swimming. Not the coolest sport in the world when you're at school, you know, it's football or rugby. But that was my passion and I was brave enough to follow it. And hopefully they go away with a sense of, well, yeah, if he can do it, I can do it. Well, we've done some success tools with them, so talking about planning for success and various different bits and pieces, but also putting it into practice, because it's all right knowing the theory, it's all right understanding it and being able to talk about it. There's another thing when you're under pressure, you're in a team, or you're around your peers who are taking the mickey out of you, it's a different set of tools then. So putting them under a bit of pressure, working in pairs, working in groups, working on their own, and really finding out where they fit into their teams. And it was really interesting because some just follow the crowd and I was asking them to step out from the crowd, be different, don't be frightened. You might get laughed at, but you'll have the last laugh when you're successful.